In het land van Brexit, premier May is een absoluut fenomeen. En omdat ze volgende week voor het eerst naar Nederland komt, leek dit ons het moment om haar op te zoeken in haar woonplaats Cardiff. Maar wat gebeurde er?
Het waren de dagen van de niet eerder vertoonde maartse sneeuwstormen. Natuurlijk, dit soort weersomstandigheden biedt ook kansen. En het levert mooie plaatjes op. Maar dit hadden ze in Wales nog niet eerder meegemaakt. Alles was ontregeld. Op internet verscheen zelfs een video die de wereld overging. Van een boer die zijn schaap moest uitgraven. Gevolg van dit alles. Onze vlucht werd gecanceld.
En dat Miss Jones haar agenda verder nauwelijks ruimte liet, deden we het anders. En hadden we kort voor deze uitzending van hieruit contact met de hoofdrolspeelster uit die veelgeprezen musical Sunset Boulevard. Die musical is al meer dan 25 jaar een absolute wereldhit, dankzij de fameuze componist Andrew Lloyd Webber. Hij zag de film uit 1950 en dacht, dat unieke verhaal ga ik omwerken voor theater.
Somebody with polo ponies, a big shot.
What you're trying to say is you don't want me to love you.
Ja, die film.
What is it?
Nothing, madame.
Ik heb hem weer eens bekeken en dan denk je, hoe heerlijk kan het zijn? Alles in overweldigend zwart-wit. Geweldige automobielen. Dramatische scènes.
What are you gonna do, Joe? What are you gonna do?
Hoofdrolspelers met voor de pensioengerechtigden onder ons legendarische namen als Gloria Swanson en William Holden.
Because they want to see me, me, Norma Desmond.
Je begrijpt meteen waarom Lloyd Webber dacht, dit is goud.
Madame is the greatest star of them all.
En nu komt de complete Engelse cast van 55 man, inclusief 16 man orkest, voor 2 weken naar Koninklijk Theater Carré in Amsterdam. Met Ria Jones in de hoofdrol. And there we see her in Cardiff. Hello, Miss Jones.
Hello, Ivo.
Well, let's say Ria is not a usual name for a Welsh girl, is it?
No, it's not actually. I'm going to tell you the story. It's a lovely story. My parents, when they were younger, before I was born, were on holiday in Sitges in Spain. And they met a couple from Holland who had a daughter named Ria. And my parents loved the name so much that they said, if we have a girl next, we'll name her Ria.
Yeah.
And it was me, and that's why I was called Ria.
Beautiful story. So we have a kind of Dutch connection here, haven't we?
There is a Dutch connection, absolutely. They were Mr. and Mrs. de Roy from Amsterdam, and we kept in touch for many years, but we've lost touch now. But their daughter was called Ria, and my father loved the name so much. I was named after her.
Yeah. Reading about your career, there's one thing I could hardly believe. Is it true that when you were only 19 years old, you already played the part of Evita Peron in the musical Evita?
That's right, and I believe I'm the youngest ever to play the role. I was actually 18 when I was cast, and then 19 when I actually performed the role, yes. It was very exciting, and I think that was the first break that I had.
Unbelievable, but you had to play an adult woman there, of course. How did you manage? How difficult was it?
You know, when you're that young, I think you don't really think too much. I think if I got the role now, I'd be terrified. But at that age, I was just, let's do it.
Yeah, let's do it. Well, if we talk about the musical Sunset Boulevard, if I'm well informed, about more than 25 years ago already, you were contacted by the great Andrew Lloyd Webber about the main part of Norma Desmond.
That's right. He always performs his new musicals in front of friends, agents and producers at his home in Sidmonton. So I was the first person to sing the role. And I found a letter that he'd written me shortly afterwards, thanking me for bringing Norma Desmond to life. And that was 1991. And I joked with him at the time that I knew I was way too young then because Norma Desmond's 50. And I said, maybe one day I'll get to do the revival. And here I am at 50, playing the role. It's quite remarkable. Yeah, it's been such a great ride.
In overcrowded hallways, so much to say, not just today, but always. We'll have early morning madness. We'll have magic in the making.
Well, If you have to describe the character of Norma Desmond, who is she?
Well, she's the fading movie star from the silent movie era, and she can't quite give up the fact that her star has faded. So she spends her days in her mansion with her butler, Max, hoping that one day she will return to the talkies and become the movie star she once was. But the story is an amazing story with, I think, one of the most dramatic endings to a musical ever.
Yeah. Die rol van Norma Desmond werd in 2016 in Londen gespeeld door de Amerikaanse filmster Glenn Close. Bekend van films als Fatal Attraction met Michael Douglas. Maar door ziekte moest ze het na een aantal voorstellingen laten afweten. 4 avonden nam Rhea Jones haar rol over. Het publiek was aanvankelijk diep teleurgesteld, voelde zich genomen. We hebben een peperduur kaartje betaald om die Amerikaanse movie star hier aan het werk te zien. En dan krijgen we de Engelse Rhea. Well, Miss Jones, that must have been extremely difficult. How was it for you?
The first performance, when they announced that Glenn Close was off due to illness, there were boos and people shouting for their money back. But I knew necessarily it wasn't at me, it was more at the fact that Glenn Close wasn't appearing that night. I understood because people had paid a lot of money, had travelled many miles to see her, and she wasn't performing. But as we say in the business, the show must go on, and it had to go on, and that was my job. So I just took the opportunity, and after my first song, they went crazy. And at the end, they gave me a very long, wonderful standing ovation. So I was delighted, I was emotional. It was an incredible 4 shows. How 4 shows can change your career path, having performed for over 5 years, how 4 shows can change that path, being at the right place at the right time, the right age and the right show.
Yeah, now you're coming to the Koninklijk Theatre Carré. How is that?
I'm so proud to be bringing it to Amsterdam as well. So excited. I just hope it won't be snowing.
Well, you're coming to the European continent. Will that have any sort of influence on a soft and friendly Brexit? What do you think?
Oh, don't talk about that. Oh, I just wish we were staying. That's all I'm saying. I was gutted, but there you go. I cast my vote, but, you know, fingers crossed it'll change, but I don't know.
Okay, Miss Jones, thank you very, very much. And hopefully we'll see each other next week in Amsterdam.
I cannot wait. Thank you, Ivo, and hello to you all. I look forward to meeting you all soon.
Okay, bye-bye. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye. Thank you.
To dream.